Hey guys, it's Convertible Turtle again for this morning's Crypt of the Necrodancer half-hour stream. Kind of making this a regular thing. We'll see what we can do about these mushroom dudes and get a little game on. Those of you that may have remember watching last stream might have remembered me taking on finally. That was horrible. We'll call that a warm-up, right? Might remember I finally took on one of the guys that were the bosses and finally beat them, and that unlocked this wonderful world that we're in now, where even the walls themselves try to attack us. So we'll see what we got going on here. Kind of cool. Got all its gold. That mushroom blew up on us. Oh, you can get shopkeeper. We definitely are. Not doing this playthrough either. That's kind of the way it goes with this game. Glass shard. Not sure that's good. Just really bad. Okay, they kind of do the Michael Jackson zombie thing. Shimmy the left, shimmy the right, and then they're done shimmy. Oh, cool. The glass shard breaks when you throw it, so that's good to know too. Alright, we've got 102. Much rather have the bright torch. Much rather have an actual titanium broadsword than a glass broadsword. Oh, that's what I get for another song. Whoa! That was an interesting thing to know, by the way. All sorts of neat stuff coming, of course, in the next level. And those of you that might be joining us, I'm not saying anything, I apologize. I still don't got my thicket monitor hooked up. Yeah, but that's actually going to be one of the goals after I finish the stream today, to get that hooked up before we go. And we got 2 gemstones. That's not enough to do anything in the lobby, unfortunately, so we'll just go quick restart. And we'll just tab over so we can see if anybody's actually talking to us. Oh, nobody in the chat right now, but that's alright. Ability to fail at this game will not anytime soon fail to impress me. Oh, we definitely like the miner's helmet. And down we go again. Alright. Let's see if anybody else is talking. Hey, it's Foxy. Hey, Foxy. Welcome to the Crypt of the Necrodancer stream. Still don't have my second monitor, so the chat will be a little bit on the delayed side. But yeah, we finally got to level 2 in this game, and we're starting to finally play. Oh, this is going to be a pretty quick reset. So I figure out what the hell is going on real fast. Definitely not really happy with the Shroud of Darkness I just found by accident. That's not good for anybody. At least, with the lights out, you are able to rob the shopkeeper. So there's that. We can actually do something worse than just rob the shopkeeper. We can kill the shopkeeper, because we had two bombs. Hopefully lights will come on. Nope. That's what I get for hoping. So we're down to one heart. We managed to kill a shopkeeper. Kill does with a bat. We got 4 gems, so we'll go to the lobby and spend some money and say hi. Cool, yeah, no problem with that at all. No problem with chilling. I'm just here to kind of play before I head to bed today and just have a good time.
Hi.
Yeah, still not sure about this rapier. I don't like when it's a lunge for double damage, when they tell you gotta do instructions and stuff. I'm just not a big fan of that, because I'm not really willing to kind of put in the thought process, I guess. Transforms all non-equipped items. Since we don't have anything for 4, I guess that's what we're going to do anyways. We'll go for +1 damage. We like having bonus damage. Alright, we can see again. So, for future reference, we do not want to have anything to do with these torches that happen to be shrines. Oh, we are getting our butt handed to us. And we're still not learning. Yeah, we're dead. Alright, restart that. Thank you. 18 coins. What will that get us? Nothing, really. Welcome back, Foxy. Gonna see what we can figure out this next time through. Quick restart, we got no gems. I gotta remember that, guys. After you hit him, you gotta skip the beat. Hey, holster. 11 coins. Probably not worth it to look into the shopkeeper. We get to him at the moment. Hey, find better items. I'll definitely do some better items. And not afraid to blow up a skeleton either. Lots of rip on this game, Foxy. It's basically the genre is a roguelike, but on top of that, it's a rhythm game. And that's kind of where I get the problem sometimes. Yeah. It's... Dying a lot is kind of the game plan in the new game. While you learn everything, get all the patterns down. And the real fun thing is I usually play this before heading to bed, and pattern recognition skills are not the best. I'm getting slightly better. I think I saw a gem glint. Hey, I actually found the gem this time. I believe that means when I die, which is about to happen pretty quick. I'll have something to show for it this time. Oh, dead. Alright, so this time we'll go to the lobby, and we actually go to one of these stores here.
Hello.
And we'll get the pickaxe, because why not? Yeah, it kind of is like Pokemon Mystery Dungeon in a sense. You don't get the extra Pokemon to kind of help you, and there's not really the type system here that Pokemon Mystery Dungeon has. But what you do have is every boss, every monster, every animal has its pattern, and as evidenced by the fact that I keep getting hit by them all the time, I have yet to figure out that the skeletons, the shield, jump, and then wait, and then jump, and then when you hit them, they jump again. I'll figure it out eventually, though. The real fun thing about this also is that there's, like, full-scale box battles. And the shopkeeper is awesome with the way he sings. The full-scale boss battles, each boss has its own full entire screen devoted to it. And they have their own patterns. And their own mechanics. So if you like that kind of thing, like in MMOs and whatnot, it actually makes this pretty interesting. And there's multiple characters that you unlock as you play through the game. And those characters have their own kind of thing as well. We got enough money to buy what we just want to buy. Yeah, we need 40. So we get the apple, which up and left will let us eat. And we got the broadsword. The broadsword will actually let us attack a narc in front of us. It's like right here. I hit the mushroom there. Man. Oh, I get the slow strong thing now. Means I can beat these things, but it takes two hits. If I like that. I'll keep with it for a while though. No clue what that Nightmare Horse did. 2 coin gems, not enough. So, wow, we're getting some slowdown. I'll go to lobby. I've been noticing a little bit of frame drop. Not sure what's causing that right away. So the rhythm, yeah, the flashing, the heartbeat at the bottom is part of the rhythm. On the beat, the monsters move. And off the beat, the monsters don't move anywhere. The gold that they drop multiplies as long as you're keeping the beat. And the actual dungeons have traps that you can hit on. Fast forward and rewind. Fast forward actually speeds up. Rewind actually slows down the actual beats as well. And the actual songs themselves, the background music that you're hearing, is actually music that, I'm gonna stay and spin diamond and see if there's anything on these other guys to get. I totally lost my train of thought. It derailed and killed all of its passengers. Apologize for that. So the songs themselves actually have a beginning, middle, overture, bridge, and an end, like real music does.
How's it going?
And plus one damage, kill dash. Interesting. We'll unlock that. Didn't realize that was a thing. But yeah, so when the song itself ends, no matter where you're at in the dungeon, a trapdoor will actually... Whoa, that thing was huge. It took more than one hit, too. Interesting. Oh, we're already dead. We'll just quick restart that. But yeah, so you could actually be not really at the beginning of the dungeon, but in the middle of it. Or you could wind up being in a trap room, even, if you're not careful, where you can you're actually game at. So you kind of want to make sure that you keep the rhythm of the music and the song itself to play. Yeah, I'm actually not really getting that whole entire 3-beat rhythm there. that was not good. But you'll notice the way I walk right now is keeping the beat. But I can kind of go faster and now lose the beat. And the coloring of it goes down, the disco effect is what they call it, actually goes away. And with the disco effect on, damage modifiers, gold modifiers, all that goes away. And so it's really enticing you to kind of keep the beat. And one of the neat things that they've done with this game to kind of help drive that point home is you can actually play this game with the Dance Dance Revolution controller. I no longer have a home controller, so I can't do that at the moment, but it has made me think about where I could possibly acquire one just for friends and giggles. And maybe do like a cam reveal or something, where you can see me and my ridiculousness dancing and trying to figure out a way. Alright, quick restart. Yeah, it's definitely an interesting mechanic. I mean, and the fact that the game name is actually called Crypt of the Necrodancer, just makes it funny on top of all that. Ah, man. Freaking skeletons. One of these days I'll actually have that down, maybe. Yeah, these are here. Basically, trap tiles all look like this. So that's a trap. Over here's a trap that actually spawns a bomb. And over here are the walls that are going to start trying to attack me if you get too close to them. Yeah, those dudes right there that do the whole entire rock golem thing, they're basically the same thing as the skeletons. You'd think by now I'd have them figured out. I can do the rock golems pretty easy. But nope, not apparently in my cards. Alright, so that's the actual stairs that I've unlocked. Technically, I'm at the end of the dungeon. But the things that I have yet to acquire in this dungeon is I don't know where the shopkeeper is. So that's a problem. Oh, I ran away. That guy way too fast. Ah, dead. Could have made it to the next level. Just got greedy. We'll go to lobby and see if we can get anything with our two gems.
Hey.
3, 6, and 3. Nope. 8 and 12, so still no on those.
Hello.
Nothing there. Alright. Yeah, if you like rhythm games, it's definitely one to try out, because you kind of get to the point to where you're learning the songs, learning the beats. Even the boss battles have a whole lot to do with the actual mechanic of the dance beat and all that. Now here's one of those things here, like, if you're hearing the music in the background in a few seconds. You can hear where the actual tempos drop. Eventually the tempo will come back off the tracks. But one thing that these developers have done that's kind of sneaky, in my opinion, is the enemies all can hit the trap. There's one room that had several of these, tempo up and tempo down, and the actual monsters would jump on the trap, and you basically lost your beat if you weren't paying attention to everything. That's another thing, too, is if you do something that's an invalid move, you will lose the tempo. And one of the things that I'm bad about is these little rocks here. The gray one that I'm kind of dancing around. It's actually not breakable with the shovel. And that's considered an invalid move. So the game basically says, oh, you missed a speed, you missed a step. You know, kind of like missing a dance step in a dance. Looks kind of neat. Oh, And that's me getting beat down by the skeletons yet again. Lucky for me, the skeletons seem to both travel in pairs. Both travel in pairs. Ah, that's funny. But at least as soon as one wipes me out, I, generally speaking, missed that grab. Alright. Generally speaking, I usually get the actual beat. Hey, there's the key to that chest. Now, the question is, where do we leave that thing laying at? Oh, there it is. Oh, that sounds like a dragon. Well, rip dip potato chip. Bet we did get enough gems to actually get something in the lobby, so that's always good. Wish I had 8, but it is what it is. 10 kills to equal health. Yeah, that sounds good. So the leftmost place and the rightmost place, and you notice I'm buying all this stuff and it doesn't really do me any good. It just adds it to the loot table for the dungeons. And yeah, let me see here. I think one thing I'll do real quick, because I don't think I'll be able to get a full clear before I'm actually going to in-stream, but I can go over here to the bosses that I've unlocked, and it's just the one, but kind of give you an idea of the boss battles. So this is basically the way the room spawns. Kind of hear the music going. This particular boss is a chessboard. I'm about to get really badly beaten. With all the queens just spawned there. So the idea on this battle is that while you're on the beat, you can hear the beat in the background, you gotta beat all the chess pieces. And much like any chess game, there is some strategy involved. Oh yeah, I'm about to get another queen on me. But I was able to time her out. Oh. Yeah, and he's a king. And his big deal is he can attack anywhere he wants, but he's unlike the queen. And the fact that he can, you know, only move so many spares at once. Hopefully we'll get a chance to kill this guy real quick. That's me really biting the big one here. Alright. Yeah, that's going to go very bad for us. That's basically that boss mechanic. You gotta get a beat on him to basically keep pushing him back and make him rush you. But yeah. And this right here is, you know, just training mode. So it gets you an idea so you can be able to beat the bosses. Yeah, me too. Like, it really lets you on that particular boss battle intuitively get, oh my goodness, what's going on? Oh, it's chess. And so if you actually ever play chess, you know that the pieces do what they do. And this last little bit here that I'm going to do is pretty much just me cheesing the game for a little bit, because this is the original zone 1, and I know most of the enemies here and play a little bit better on it. Don't know the maps though, because the maps are all random procedurally generated stuff. And that's the thing that just happened there, is the Crown of Thorns I equipped actually damaged me to put on my head. So that was kind of cool. That looks awfully suspicious, like something's inside it. No, alas, it's not. And another thing I like about this game is it plays into the gaming tropes really well. This is the first level, right? And so it's slimes that and bats and skeletons. And then some random kind of sub-boss. In this case, it's the Minotaur. And everybody knows, you know, like, slimes are pretty much harmless things. Not really sure where the monkey plays into it, but I'm pretty sure that's what they've gone for. See, got all my hearts, got enough money to go back and get my stuff, and enough time, I've basically cleared the dungeon at this point. Yeah, you can tell I've played the initial dungeon a lot more than the second dungeon. I don't even need the extra spear, because I already got a spear from another chest. In a few seconds, the actual song is probably going to end. I'm going to dance around this little chest here, or this trapdoor, so you can kind of see what happens when the song actually ends with a good level. End it, and then I just drop down. And if I wasn't near where this actual chest was, or this, not the chest, but the stairs, I would actually not be in a good area, because somewhere in this level is actually going to be an area that's either like where the boss is, or where whole slathering of everything trying to kill me all at once is. Like, there's a couple rooms that are just filled with bats. One bat's not a problem. A whole room full of them? That can kind of, you know, ruin your day. There's the shopkeep. That's another thing that I like about it, is the shopkeeper scenes. And at first it looks like this really cool kind of just ambiance thing, because of the genre we're in, you know, the rhythm game. But the fact that he sings and you can hear him when you're not nearby is actually really cool, because it's a nice hint that's what's going on. Where are you at? What are you doing? There's a shopkeeper nearby, so you probably need to go there. And, you know, just little touches like that. See, you can see in the bottom right corner that I've explored this map completely. but there's no reason to stay, so we'll go down. So the little jellyfish looking things, they actually look, and mechanically at least, like the boos from Mario. They're a ghost and they stay incorporeal until you look away. And that was one of the things that actually took me quite a while to figure out, that they were basically boos, and it's one of the things I should have picked up on much. Nintendo is a fit throughout my life. But when I finally figured out, I was like, oh, wow, okay. Well, we haven't heard the guy sing. We have... managed to beat the boss, though. Closer. What's he selling? The blood sword does a lot of damage, but the thing with a lot of the blood weapons that I just passed is that what I've noticed is they have a limit on how many hits you can do with them, and then they despawn. Was not aware of that at all until the first time I got one, and then boom.
Death metal.
Okay, this is a boss I don't know. So, yay. Wow. Wow, the rhythm here is going to be insane. You're kidding me.
Dad was always was coming and going on his adventures.
I have no clue what
this
I did
time
there.
He seemed more excited.
But I did beat.
He said he'd found it.
Beat
some
Zone
great
one
treasure.
So that's kind of cool.
When I was older, I found the notes you left behind. Directions to a graveyard.
Uncle Eli tried to stop me, but Dad had been gone for 2 years. I had to find him.
So the first time I actually beat this level, I unlocked Uncle Eli. Wow. Kind of disappointed about Death Metal after all the problems that I had with the last bosses. But I'm not going to complain too much. But yeah, guys, it's time to kind of end the stream here. I'm about to call it a night, or call it a day, however you want to call it. But yeah, that there is Crypt of the Necrodancer again. Still not getting all the way through. Oh yeah, the soundtrack is great. You can actually download the soundtrack on Steam as well, and separately. And but yeah, all right. Hey, Selig, thanks for joining the stream, man. Sorry for not saying hi. I've still got the second monitor not hooked up yet. But yeah. And but guys, yeah, thanks for watching. I know it's another short one. I'll kind of probably make this a habit of in the mornings doing a short Necrodancer, because it's just easy to pick up, easy to put down. But I appreciate it. Like, share, comment, subscribe, do all those cool things, and I'll see you guys later.